Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we're going to be looking at redstone repeaters. I'm going to load up a world that I've created for you already. And in this world, I'm going to be using redstone repeaters to create a fireworks display. Now, we've looked at using a dispenser and redstone to launch one firework, but using redstone repeaters, we can set a delay, so we can have a fireworks display, so we can stand back and watch the display as it unfolds, which is pretty useful. Now, in this world, what I've done is I've coded an agent. So let's have a look at the code builder for this guy. Here it is, firework. And on chat command run, he's going to move forward one and then back by one, wait 4 seconds, and repeat that 8 times. So let's have a look at how that's going to affect our fireworks. So in front of our agent, we've got our pressure plate, our pressure pad, and we're going to have the agent stand on that, and straight away it's going to go to these three repeaters. Now, repeaters will first of all boost your redstone signal. So normally without repeaters, the redstone signal will go 15 blocks before it runs out. But if you put some repeaters in there, you can extend, kind of boost that signal and increase the strength of it. The second thing that they will do is they can add a delay. So if I interact with this one here, you'll see each time I click, the distance between these two kind of little mini redstone torches, I guess they are, increases. So the bigger the distance, the more the delay. Okay, now, as we go through this, there'll be a big delay here, and then we have a little junction. So on the left, we have a channel that leads to three different dispensers, and we've got one with a small delay, one with a medium delay, one with a large delay. The rest of the signal goes through these three repeaters, each with a large delay. Then it goes to the next three, same again, small delay, medium delay, large delay, another three. Then with another three going to dispensers, another three set at the full delay, another four dispensers this time, just to show you, you can use a combination of different values. We've got one with a large delay, one with a small delay there next to each other. And then finally, another three. Right, let's set these to the largest delay to keep it all the same. And then these ones finally lead to three different ones each with their own different delay. Now, I'm pretty sure that what should happen here is when the agent stands on the pad, each dispenser should receive the signal at a slightly different time. And by the time it gets to the end, the agent will stand on the pressure pad again, and that will set the whole sequence going again. Now, in each of these dispensers, we have different types of fireworks. We've got some light blue ones in here, got some light grey ones in here, and so on. And when you are placing these dispensers, it's a good idea to get above the ground, directly above them, so that they are pointing up. You don't want the fireworks firing off in any other direction, really. Then all that's left to do is to get the agent to move forward and have a look to see how this works. Let's go ahead and press T and forward slash time set night, and we'll let the sun go down there so we can enjoy our fireworks display. Okay, so if I go to my agent's coding by pressing C, just check this. So I'm going to press run and it's going to execute that. So let's press T to go to our typing commands, and then I will type run and let's see how we do. There we go, and the agent is moving backwards and forwards. The fireworks display is going off. It's looking pretty good. And we can just sit and enjoy this. You know, this is something your students, for example, could add in at the end of a level. You know, we did the maze previously. Maybe at the end of the maze, stand on the pressure pad, there's a chalkboard that says look up, and they're treated to a nice fireworks display. Now, if you want the agent to repeat that more than 8 times, it's just a simple matter of changing the coding. If you want the delays to be slightly different, you can go through and adjust some of these. You can add more dispensers. You can have rows and rows and rows of dispensers going back and do a really big fireworks display. But really, the point of this exercise today is just to look at how repeaters work. There's a lot of things that repeaters can do, obviously functions like clocks and things like that, and timers. They are quite good for delaying, any kind of delaying an action, switching tracks on your roller coaster, for example, and things like that. And using the agents, set off the fireworks again. Using the agent as a delay as well to push the button. So you could have if you wanted to make it a bit tricky for yourself, you could have a big row of agents all pressing different buttons at slightly different times. Like I say, this is just a good way to learn how the repeaters work. So just adding a delay and strengthening the signal. Now we'll be doing more tutorials coming up. So we're going to look at, on the Minecraft Education website, the code town, and look at how we can complete the code town and use it with our students. So if you want to see those things, do make sure you like and subscribe to the channel so that you're notified when those come up. But for now, thanks for tuning in, and goodbye.